a true fact. Netflix takes over your life. Take it from experience. Hello, my name is Bianca Piper, and this was Getting Old. You're watching A Reader's World. Up in July because basically I only read one book, so I'm just gonna put that in with my August wrap-up. So today I'll be telling you the book and the books that I read from July to August. Let's get started. The reasons why I didn't read almost any books in July was I had camp, and when I got straight home from camp I would watch Supernatural till 12 o'clock at night. So basically blame Netflix. Raise your hand if Netflix has affected your reading. If you didn't raise your hand, you are a liar. Or you just don't watch Netflix. So the only book I read in July was Weird Things Customers Say in Bookshops by Jem Campbell-Bell? Campbell? I don't know. This was such a fun read and showed the stupidity of humanity. If you think you're dumb, go read that book. Then you'll realize you're probably the smartest person on earth compared to those people. Now, the first book I read in August was for the Booktubeathon, and that book was A Walk to Remember by Nicholas Sparks. I've never read any other Nicholas Sparks books. Now I know why. In my opinion, his writing style's not that great, and also the romance wasn't that great either. I also didn't like Landon. Landon was kind of annoying. The one good thing about this book, though, was the ending. It was kind of sweet and satisfying. The second book I read for Booktubeathon was Aquamarine by Alice Hoffman. The movie of this book was my childhood. I went to see it in the theater, dragged my mom and my aunt to it, and absolutely loved it. Watched it every night. But this book, I think this book was written more towards 5, 6, or 7, and 8-year-olds, more than young adult, but it still was bad. This book takes place in one day. I know it's like this many pages, but still. Like, one day, the characters aren't developed. The world isn't developed. Nothing in that book was good. But I do have to say the writing style was okay. It wasn't that bad. It like showed what the characters looked like and everything. The main problem I had with this book, but did a great job in the movie, was the two best friends. This book showed nothing of their relationship together, but in the movie, they have such chemistry together, it's amazing. And like, the movie showed like, what problems they had with the girl moving, but in the book, they're just like, okay, she's moving. I'm just like, what? The next book, I'm really sad about presenting because this was the last book I read on the beach. And that was Second Chance Summer by Morgan Matson. The thing that made me stumble onto this book was I had enough money to buy a book before I went to the beach. And I was looking for a kind of cutesy beach contemporary. And when I found this book and had Morgan Matson's name on it, I'm like, I'm hooked. Put that in my shopping cart. I loved Since You've Been Gone, and I wanted to read more Morgan Matson books. And I absolutely loved this book too. I did like Since You've Been Gone a little more, but still, this is pretty close. I love how she writes her characters and her writing style and her stories. Read Morgan Matson. They're good to read during the summer, so read when summer comes back in 9 months. There is one problem I had with this book. It's hilarious, but so dumb. The main character goes into town and keeps running in to her ex-boyfriend. It's hilarious. It is just like, she goes into the bakery. Oh yeah, he works there. Moves into your old summer home. Oh yeah, now he's your next door neighbor. The fourth book I read in August was Between the Lines by Jobicool and Samantha Van Leer. This is one of the most creative books I have ever read. If you haven't heard of this book, it is about a girl who finds a fairy tale in her library, reads it all the time, and starts to kind of fall in love with the prince inside the fairy tale. Basically, she has a fictional crush on this prince, and then he starts talking to her. This girl is so lucky. Just imagine it right now. You're reading your favorite book. Your fictional crush talks back to you, starts to fall in love with you, wants to get out of the book and be with you. I'm giving this a try. Hello? Percy? Anyone home? Can you hear me? Then I read the second book to that, which was Off the Page by the same authors. This book takes place months after the events of the first one, and I did enjoy this book, but this one was very slow pace for me. Like, I felt like I was like 200 pages in, but I was only like 100 pages in. But I still very much enjoyed it. So I recommend you read both books, not just this one. Now, here are the books I'm going to be reading in September, which is right now. The book I'm currently reading now is The Fifth Wave by Rick Yancey. The trailer got released yesterday, and I've been deciding to reread this book because basically I didn't really understand much of it. So I'm just going to reread it. Another book I'm currently reading is I'm Number 4 by some guy. I can't say your name. Oh my god, my books drop! Just to warn you, this isn't a part of the Divergent series. Get it? You get it. I saw the movie and it was okay. I never finished it, so I want to read the book. And I've heard the series is good. This month, I've decided to be dauntless and challenge the two most overhead books I have on my bookshelf, and that is Cinder and Legend. I need to read these before someone kills me. Or the two fandoms kill me before I can reach them because I haven't read them yet. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you like, comment, subscribe. Comment down below, what fictional character would you love them to talk back to and bring them into the real world? Percy Jackson would be a good choice. See you next video. Bye!